Okay, this is for Algebra 1. We are classifying polynomials. This is the lesson for 14.1, and this is going to be into two different videos, so just to let you know for this lesson. First of all, polynomial. Poly means many, and so a polynomial can be one monomial or the sum of more than one monomial. Remember, what a monomial is one term, but it can be a number, a variable, or a product of numbers and variables that have a whole number exponent. Can't have a negative exponent, and it can't be more than one term for a monomial. And it cannot have a variable in the denominator. So you're gonna watch that. So the thing is, a monomial, if you have more than one monomial, then we call it a binomial. So two terms is a binomial. Three terms is a trinomial. If you get any further than that, then they're usually just called a polynomial. Okay, then polynomials are also classified by the degree of the polynomial. So this isn't one of those make or break things, like you'll ruin your whole algebra career and math career if you don't understand the degree of polynomials, but I just wanted you to understand what they're talking about. If you see that, you know how to get it. So what the degree is, or how to find the degree of a polynomial, is where you have the greatest sum of the exponents on the variables in each term. So I know that sounds confusing, but it's the sum of the exponents on the variables of each term. So we're gonna look at both examples here. Classify each polynomial by its degree and the number of terms. Well, I think it's easiest to find the number of terms first and then go back to the degree of the polynomial. So first of all, this subtraction, when you have subtraction or addition, that is separating your terms. So that subtraction is really a negative 5, but that is making it two different terms. So this is a two-term polynomial, which means it is a binomial. So it's a binomial, that's the number of terms. That's how you classify it, by number of terms. And now the degree. This variable has an exponent of 3. These variables, exponent of 2, x squared, and y squared. So this has 3, and then the sum of the exponents, 2 plus 2, is 4. So the degree is 4. Okay, so the degree is 4 for this polynomial. Okay, so it says the fourth degree. It's a fourth degree binomial. Now, here, so now let's look at, classify it by the terms. Well, there's two addition signs, so we have three terms, so it's a trinomial. So three terms is trinomial. Now let's watch the degrees. Be very careful. This is 3 to the fifth plus 2n squared plus 8n. Well, don't just pull this exponent, because again, in the definition, it says the exponent's on the variables. Is there any variable here? No, there's no variable. Now, if you really want to talk about it, this says 3 to the fifth has a degree of 0. Well, the reason it has a degree of 0 is because any exponent or any variable or number raised to the 0 power is going to be 1. Okay, so there's really no variable there, because you can really say the degree is 0 because it turned out to be 1, and 3 to the 5th times 1 is 3 to the 5th. Here we have n squared and we have an n. So which one has a higher degree? This one, 2. That's a larger number. So the degree is 2. So it's the second degree trinomial. Okay, so your turn. Now, I apologize, I had this written on. I taped this earlier, and there was no sound. So I have to retape it. Refilm it. Okay, so classify each polynomial by degree and number of terms. So how many terms is this? Well, it's a trinomial. So I know it's going to be a trinomial. If I can spell. Whatever. So it's a trinomial. Now, I just lost that. Five. Okay, so that was 5. X to the first, y to the first. So the degrees that you're going to add, x to the first, y squared, that's 3. X squared, y squared, that's 4. The x's and the y's, there's a 1 each exponent. So there's a 2. So this one's going to be a fourth degree trinomial. Fourth degree trinomial. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh, I spelled it wrong. Anyway, fourth degree trinomial. Check your spelling up here. Okay, this next one. I'm going to put this back now. We have A, B squared. First of all, how many terms? Two terms, so it's binomial. We have 8a to b squared, which is going to be 3. A squared b to the first, which is 3. So it is a third degree binomial. So a third degree binomial. So you can try the other two, 5 and 6. Okay, that is it for this video. You will watch the second one for simplifying polynomials.